PitchMe, Technopole Startup Incubator, empowering founders as well as PitchMe podcasts.
Welcome to the show, PitchMe.
Hello, my name is Osman Raif. I am co-founder of RobotQA. With RobotQA, we are helping our customers to find bugs in their applications and websites before their end users. And to solve this problem, we created RobotQA because if customers has any problem with their mobile application or website, they will probably lose customer, lose money, and we help them to find bugs before their end users. So with RobotQA, we are providing codeless, AI-supported test automation platform. And the tests are running on real physical devices, mobile phones. After testing, we provide a detailed report of test automation, consisting of screenshots, video capture, operating system logs, CPU memory usage, and performance logs of the test. Also, on RobotQA, you can manage your test. You create test case management, you manage your test automation, and you can integrate with a lot of test development environments. This is the product, and we've started developing RobotQA 2 years ago. And for 2 years, we developed it in, because it's kind of deep tech, we just developed it without even launching it. And we launched it May of this year. After launching, we reached more than 15 corporate customers. They are our current recursively paying customers. We have paying customers from 7 different countries, and generally our vertical is financial fintech companies. Maybe the most well-known is Turkish Airlines. They are running their test on RobotQA also. And RobotQA is platform as a service product. You can directly start using RobotQA on cloud. Currently, we have more than 100 mobile phones, physical, real, Android and iOS phones. An acceptable test automation starts with at least 100 mobile phones. And if we did not sell these 15 companies, they would probably bought more than 1,500 mobile phones. And one mobile phone has 80 kilograms of carbon footprint. So until now, we prevented 120,000 kilograms of carbon footprint by preventing them buying hundreds of mobile devices. Currently, I should a little bit talk about our market. Currently, our market size is on mobile focus only, not including the all application testing, just mobile focus is $6 billion. And CAGR is around 20%, and it will be $20 billion in just 6 years. We are located in Estonia and Istanbul in Turkey. We have two office headquarters in Estonia, and our development IT side is in Istanbul, Turkey. We generally try to differentiate from our competitors by providing end-to-end solution for our customers, which means if a customer lands on RobotQA's dashboard, they will find everything they need for automating their application testing. They can manage test cases, they can find real physical devices, they can handle reports, they can integrate with development environment. And this is kind of all-in-all ready-to-use platform. And I should maybe talk about our investment journey. We get our first investment before launching our product. We get investment with $1 million valuation 1 year ago, May of 2023. And currently, we hit 6K MRR within just 5 months. We launched our product May of this year, and in just 6 months, we hit 6K MRR. And we are going to plan hit 50K MRR at the end of next year. And we will be looking investment. We are not currently looking for investment, but we will be start looking investment in within 3 months. And we will use that investment for enlarging our sales team, because we have a ready product, it's proven, it's used by real financial companies, and we should focus on sales and increase our customer portfolio probably.
Tell me a little bit about the backstory. How was the company born?
The real story starts with our professional experience. We were working as developers in corporate companies, and as I said, we are five team members, and we know each other more than 10 years. And we were living this problem in our real life, in our professional life, and we started RobotQA by thinking there should be a solution that is creating test automation without writing any code. So we were trying to solve our own problem. So the first point, starting point, was solving our own problem.
Good. I assume there is probably plenty of companies in the market solving the same problem. What makes you special?
Yeah. In fact, we have two differentiation, main differentiation. First one is we are providing end-to-end solution, which means there are a lot of competitors, and some do not provide device farm, some do not provide test case management. So we provide all-in-all, ready-to-use, plug-in, plug-and-play solution. And the second one is we are differentiating on customer support after sales, because we have really happy customers during our journey. Because I will give a few examples. We stole a lot of customers from our competitors. And you know, generally test automation is located in India, the real market in India on test automation. And we have a lot of paying customers from India because we are stealing from our competitors, because we have a better product and easy to use product and better customer support support after sales.
The growth from 6K MRR to 50K sounds a lot. And you said that you will be, you know, raising money to have more salespeople in the team. But what's the kind of deeper strategy? How to basically grow tenfold?
In fact, test automation is kind of a new area. It's not a blue ocean, but it's not fully gained by any competitor. Yeah. So I will give one example from one small market. In Turkey, it's around $80 million 1 year budget for test automation. And if we can just capture 1% of the market, it will be even $1 million for 1 year MRR. And this is the current market. There is around 40% automation. Most of companies use manual testing. I have been in Estonia for 2 months, and in Estonia, I will not give names, but I met with biggest two companies, their engineering managers, and they are still not automating their application testing. If you close only 10 companies, it will be 50K MRR for us.
So the strategy in place, the funding is planned for the next year. What are the next big milestones?
The biggest milestones, I think we should enlarge our sales team, because we founded RobotQA as developer friends, and we are a tech-minded person. We created a perfect product. And we should talk to customers a lot more. We should tell about ourselves, and we will be probably using that strategy, because we try to touch our customers. We try to understand their real needs, and we try to provide real solution to them. So it's probably on our sales team the real solution and the key for exponential increase in income, probably in our sales team.
Good thing is that in your sector, the fact that the team is tech-minded is not a bad thing, because you're actually selling to the very tech-minded people. It's not the general consumers you're building the product for.
Yeah. Generally, the sales process generally ends by the deciding team on the our customer, and generally they are from IT part of companies, but sales part is still important, because the first touch, the first introducing of the product from sales team. But as you said, we are persuading the IT part of the target customer.
Mm. Good luck and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.